What's up, YouTube? Thanks for joining me. And today we're gonna be taking out on this beautiful day a 1995 Mitsubishi 3000GT VR4 Spyder. It's quite a treat because this one is a low mile example and it was a one owner and it's very mint. It is in a glacier white pearl exterior paint with the dark gray interior. There's only 48 of these in the whole entire United States. And the Spyder, the hardtop convertible 3000GT, was actually only offered in the United States. So on this awesome sunny day, let's go out for a coffee run and enjoy this episode. All right, so take a look at this beautiful interior. This is the dark gray, some people call it the black interior for the 3000GT. Now for the Spyder specifically, which was only built in 2 years, 1995 and 1996, this dark gray leather interior was only offered for 1995 models. So that's why it's very rare to see a white with the dark leather, the dark gray interior. So take a look how beautifully done this seat is right here, and it's very well preserved. Again, this car only has 22,000 miles on the odometer, so you would expect it to be pretty mint inside and out. It kind of has that new car smell still. So take a look at how technologically advanced Mitsubishi's interior was for the 1990s. Now, Mitsubishi wanted the driver's side and everything kind of, you know, everything kind of driver oriented, including these gauges over here. So we have a turbo gauge, we have our engine oil temperature, as well as our engine temperature gauge up here. Here's that nice cluster, the odometer, with 24,000 miles on the clock. Right here, this button, that's the ESC, electronically controlled suspension, which only came on the 95 Spyder, the 96, it was later removed. You have a state-of-the-art air conditioning and heating unit here that is just an incredible LCD screen in the center. And underneath that, you have your Infinity, which was the top of the line audio maker for Mitsubishi. You have a head unit that would require a sound engineering degree to operate. And here, Doug DeMiro, just in case you don't know, this is the equalizer. 6-speed manual transmission made by the German company Getrag. And over here, believe it or not, you have an aux cable, which is pretty cool for 1995. Mitsubishi was quite forward thinking. You have your buttons right here to lower and close the hardtop convertible. So why don't you hop on in and we'll go grab a coffee and let's go hear the boost on the road. First gear, here we go. Already you can hear that spooling. Pretty incredible how well you can hear those turbochargers despite this car being absolutely bone stock. Now compared to the first generation Mitsubishi 3000GT, which was made between 1990 to 1993, this is the second gen. And the second gen got the upgraded 6G72 motor. And what I mean by that, it got 20 more horsepower. So 320 horsepower in this car and ample torque all throughout that power band. There's not too much of a noticeable turbo lag, but certainly the turbos spool up in a way that you would think a 90s car would. So this car is bone stock, but you can hear the exhaust pretty well because it has the quad tips in the rear, and it's completely stock 6G72. So what is a 6G72? It's a legendary motor that Mitsubishi made that doesn't necessarily mean it's twin turbocharged, because the Spyder, which they made in 2 years, 1995 and 1996, in just a little bit over 1,000 units, so it is a very rare car, the 3000GT Spyder. However, there was an SL trim and the VR4 trim. The VR4 is really the one you want. The SL trim was a front-wheel drive platform car, and it did not have twin turbochargers. It had just a regular 3-liter V6. The one you want is the VR4, and the reason why is it comes with the twin turbocharged 6G72 motor. It has all-wheel steering and all-wheel drive. It's pretty phenomenal, honestly, ahead of its time, very over-engineered. That's why it was overpriced. $65,000 in 1995. If you translate that to today's money, that's $113,000. So yeah, it did cost a pretty penny, Mitsubishi wasn't able to sell a whole lot of them as much as they intended to, and that's probably why the production was cut after two short years. So driving around town, yes, you'll feel the car's weight. Structurally, because they chopped off the top, they've reinforced these A-pillars as well as the side sills on the bottom of the car. So this car is a little porky. It's over 4,000 pounds easily. However, you have some sweet gadgetry underneath the car that makes it feel a little more nimble. So the all-wheel steer going into these corners up here makes it feel like a shorter wheelbase than it actually is. As well as you have electronically controlled suspension, which is only on the 1995 model. So as I go around this bend, it levels itself out and it's a little bit firmer. So that way I feel better driver feedback in this 3000GT. So right now we're gonna go grab a coffee and we're gonna head to a classic car show, which is mostly full of muscle cars, but I think it'll be pretty cool to show off this one because being built in 1995, it's getting close to that historic range. And you know what? This will be a classic car. This 3000GT video is brought to you by Dunkin' Donuts. Just kidding, they're not paying me enough to do that. But let me tell you why this car is so special to me. It's because every day since high school, I'd always be checking every single car online dealer, Auto Trader, Cars.com for a 3000GT Spyder with low miles, because I knew one day this would be a future classic. And I also really love Mitsubishis. If you want to see a video of a clean Eclipse, you can check out the video over here. Not by that guy passing by. But let me tell you something about this car, is when I first saw it for sale last November online, the day it was posted, I called the owner. He lived up in Poughkeepsie, New York, which wasn't too far from where I live in North New Jersey. So I grabbed at the chance and I called him up and I was telling him all about the car and how much I loved it, put a deposit on, and then within a week's time, I was able to say I was the second owner, proud owner of this 3000GT Spyder. So what I want to do with the car is not modify it. I just want to keep it pretty clean, very clean, but very original. Just kind of restore it back to that showroom quality. There's a little bit of things here and there that need to be worked on, but nothing major. So if you'll continue to watch this series, which I hope you do, please subscribe and watch more of the cool episodes that we'll have out on this 3000GT. Now let's head out to the car show. Cheers. What I like about this car, it's a 1963 split window Corvette and is beautifully restored in this white color here. But if you take a look at this one here, this is an all original example of a 1963 split window. If you get up close, you can definitely tell that color is the original patina. Thank you for joining us today on the first episode of many. I do hope you subscribe to our channel, but I also hope that you enjoyed this muscle car show, even though this car is not really much of a muscle car. So, fine day for a Spyder, huh?